everybody. Welcome to the first class in soft skills. I'm sure all of you have been attending some CRT classes, and in intermediate you have attended a lot of classes on subjects and languages. But these classes that I'm going to take are different. So you may ask, how are they going to be different? They're not going to teach you anything. They're not going to tell you anything. They're just going to make you think. Think as to how you can be a better student, a better person, and a better all-rounder in all the ways that you can be. So the first topic for today that I have chosen, which is one of the main or the most important things for a person to become better, is attitude. And when I say attitude, there are two kinds of attitude: positive attitude and negative attitude. So when anybody says attitude, what they mean is positive attitude. I'm sure nobody would be suggesting you have a negative attitude. So whenever I mention the word attitude, please think of it as positive attitude. So what is positive attitude? How can you develop positive attitude? How can you progress with positive attitude? And why are successful people, you know, so intent on having a good attitude? We'll learn all these things today. I'm sorry to say the word learn. We're going to see all these things today and then assess for ourselves whether it's good to have a positive attitude or a negative attitude. Come on, let's start. So, what is attitude? It is your point of view. Suppose you see a beggar begging on the streets. You would probably say that I'm going to help him because he needs the money. That could be, and that is your point of view. That is your attitude. But there could be somebody else who thinks that if you encourage beggars, they will not work for themselves. That is also a different kind of attitude. So attitudes can be of different kinds. So what is the attitude that you have, and how much of it is positive and how much of it is negative? Like, you know, let me start with a small story. Once, you know, there was a mother who was taking her child onto the beach. I'm sure all of you have been to different beaches, maybe the Kakinada beach or the Vizag beach or the Marina beach in Chennai. So when you go on the beach, oh, there are lots of small children, and surely there's one fellow selling balloons. And similarly, one day when the mother was taking her son to the beach, he saw a balloon seller selling a lot of colorful balloons. And this boy wanted one really badly. And then they asked the price, and he said it's 10 rupees each. So the mother thought, they were not really very well to do. So the mother thought that she could put this 10 rupees to better use, and she pulled her child along and said, come on, let's not have a balloon, not take a balloon, we'll do something else. But the child was adamant, or he really wanted a colorful balloon. So finally, after a long walk or a long time, he convinced his mother to buy him a balloon. He said he would forego whatever eatery she was planning to buy for him. He said, then mother said, okay, you can go and buy the balloon. But by this time, what happened was, the balloon seller had sold almost all his balloons. There was only one balloon left, and that was a black balloon. Till then, he had all colors: white, pink, blue, green, red, and of course black. But everybody had chosen all the, you know, bright, beautiful colors, and the only balloon left was a black balloon. This child was very upset. He went and asked the balloon fellow that will this balloon, though it's black, will it fly as high as the others because it's black? And you know what the balloon fellow said? He said, it's not the color of the balloon that matters. It's what inside it that matters. It's the air inside the balloon that takes it up. It's not the color. It doesn't mean that a black balloon will fall down and a white balloon will fly up. So it's what's inside the balloon. If you fill the balloon with sand and water, what will happen? It will fall to the ground. If you fill it with air, it's sure going to fly. But I'm sure you've heard of this nitrogen. Nowadays, they're filling it with nitrogen. What happens when you fill it with nitrogen? Nitrogen is lighter than air, so it goes up. So it's actually not the color of the balloon or not the shape of the balloon which makes it go up, but it's what's inside, the air that is filled inside. The lighter the air, the higher it goes. So he said, doesn't matter what's in the balloon, what the color of the balloon is, what matters is what's inside and how well it is tightened that it makes it go up. So what's the moral of that story? It says that doesn't matter how we look, how we dress, and how we, you know, how people see us. It's actually what we are that makes us go up, that makes us succeed in life. And what should we be to succeed in life? As you all know, it's the attitude. Attitude is everything. So what makes a person go up in life is his attitude. So I'm sure, I don't know how many of you have seen this or heard this. I'm sure you all can see this. This is not an interactive class, so I can't ask you, but when you see something like this, I'll give you just a few seconds to think about it. What do you see? What do you see here? Okay, your time's up because it doesn't take very long. There isn't much on that slide, so it doesn't take very long for a thought to pop up in your heads. So what do you see actually? It's actually, you see, a glass which is half full or half empty. Actually, this is a psychology test that a doctor gave to some of his patients to see how, positive or negative they were, how optimistic or pessimistic they were in life. So they put a glass of water which is half full, and when somebody asked, some patients said that the glass is half full. But some others said that the glass is half empty. So depending on that answer, the doctor or the psychologist could decide whether he was an optimistic person or a pessimistic person, whether he was a positive person or a negative person. Actually, technically, the glass is completely full. Half of it is filled with water and the other half is filled with air. So technically, the glass is full, but do we see it like that? Some of us may say, oh my God, it's half empty. Some of us say, at least there's half a glass of water in that. So it's the way you look at things. And Oprah Winfrey, I don't know how many of you have heard of her. She's a big talk show host in America, and she's very popular. She's one of the top 100 influential ladies in America, women in America. So she once said, be thankful for what you have. You'll end up having more. If you concentrate on what you don't have, you will never ever, you know, have enough. So all of you, I'm sure all of you think that, you know, oh, I wish I could buy that dress, or I could have that bike that fellow has, or I could have that, I could get those marks that somebody else got. Be thankful for what you have. If you work hard, there is no way anybody can deny you more. So if you think, okay, I'm good, I can do this, and then you will get it. So it's all in the mind. So if you think you can, you're right. And if you think you can't, even then you're right. You know why? Because the mind is, it conceives and believes. If you believe it, your mind can achieve it. So first thing is belief, self-belief, that you can do it, that you can achieve it, that you want it. As long as you're confident that you have that self-belief, you can achieve anything. I don't know if you remember, I don't think most of you must have been young children, but Obama, his campaign, I'm sure you know Barack Obama, the previous president of the United States of America. So not the immediate previous, but the earlier president, one of the earlier presidents, Barack Obama, his campaign for election was, yes, we can. So with that slogan, he pulled all of America saying, yes, we can achieve more. Yes, we can reduce the debt. Yes, we can fight terrorism. So that was the positive impact he had on the people. So whenever your mind believes it, you can achieve it. If your mind itself says, you know, that I can give an example when you think of, you know, some students think that, you know, they can't study or that they can't remember. or that they can't write well, if they believe that, that I even though I study, I can't remember, that's a very negative thought to have. So how do you change that? So you study in such a way, or study less, but try to remember more. Or, you know, if you say, however I write, my handwriting is not, if you believe your handwriting is not good, it's going to remain not good. How will you improve it? How can you make that better? How can you think positive and say, how can I make my handwriting better for the next exams, in the next 6 months, next 4 months? I've got a slide on that. I'll show you how to put your, goals or targets, or how to achieve them with a positive mindset. So it has, attitude has three components. That is how you feel, how you think, and how you act. So all of us feel first, then we think about it, and then we act upon it. So all three are important for a person to have some attitude, whether it's negative or positive. These three things are important. The good thing about them is you can change all three to become better. You can change a negative attitude. You can change a negative feeling to a positive feeling. You can think positively. You can act positively. But the most difficult on this is feeling. Feeling is something which comes unconsciously, which is subconscious. So what you have to do is you have to train your subconscious mind to think positively. You know, generally whenever we're going for a competitive exam, who are the ones who score well or who come out, you know, first rankers, you ask them, they will tell you that as they were going to write the exam or the day before the exam, they've actually not studied much. They've actually relaxed and told their mind that I've done all the hard work, now is the time to recollect everything, take rest and be ready for the exam the next day. But the person who's not studied, what he'll be doing, he'll cram up everything on the last day. As a result, what happens? The mind is too jumbled to think, and you feel all confused, and you probably cannot achieve the result that you're looking for in that exam. But the people who feel that they've done justice to the syllabus, feel that they have done enough for the test, they are the ones who think that they can succeed, act, that means they write well, they perform well so that they do succeed. So it's all in the feeling. So for you to, the thing about feeling is you can't change that feeling. You can act as if you've done very well or that you have studied everything. But that deep inside you have, you know the feeling that you've not done enough or you've done well enough. That feeling is something which is very hard to change. So if you dream it, you can do it. Actions and performance precede attitude. Performance is 50% attitude and 50% ability. This is where, you know, this is another thing I wanted to tell you, is that we believe that some of us, or most of us, or most of you, that, you know, the first rank or the university first or the top in the class is not for us. We believe that we are not that, you know, good or not that we cannot achieve that much. Because we think that he's very smart. He doesn't have to read, he just knows it. He's very talented. But let me tell you, talent is something different and attitude is something more. In the sense that even though you've got a lot of talent, unless you have the right attitude, unless you put in the right hard work, unless you believe in yourself, unless you feel that you've done enough, you will not achieve success. I've got a small video on talent versus ability by one of the great commentators, Harsha Bhogle. I'm sure there are a lot of cricket fans with you. Actually, he was speaking at a talk at one of the IIMs, IMA, where he's an alumni. He studied in IMA, Harsha Bhogle. So he talks about, you know, attitude versus talent. Which is better? Is it enough to have a lot of talent and have any attitude? Or is attitude more important than talent? We'll see that video after a few minutes. So what you tell yourself every day will either lift you up or put you down. See, it's all about psychic, telling your mind. You know, that's why Again, I'll take an example from cricket. I'm sure lots of you watch cricket even if you don't play cricket. When the ball goes up in the air, when somebody hits a six, the batsman hits a six, and the ball is high up in the air, what do all the players around him say? Do they say, don't drop it, don't drop it? No. They say, catch it, catch it, catch it. You know why? When they say catch it, it has a positive frame. But when they say don't drop it, when the word don't, you know, our mind is actually, you know, also made in such a way that negativity comes a little later. You know, the mind absorbs the word drop it first and then the don't later. So she's sure to drop it. So they say catch it, catch it, catch it. And sometimes, so most of the time, they catch it depending again on their practice, on their ability. So lions just don't dream of hunting. They just do it. So that is how you should be. That's how they just hunt. They can't sit and dream that one day I will do this, one day I will hunt that, one day I'm going to have a good meal. They don't do that. They just go, see the prey, target it and hunt it down. That's how positive attitude, that's how people with a positive attitude are or should be. You know, all these business people, whether it's Ambani or Tata, Ratan Tata or anybody, whether it's Indra Nooyi or, you know, Kiran Mojumdar Shah, all these are big names in the business industry. All these people didn't sit dreaming about it. They just went and did it and then they were successful. So don't think that one day I'm going to become that. One day I'm going to be an entrepreneur. One day I'm going to set up my big business. One day I'm going to build a big house. If you keep on dreaming, nothing is going to happen. The first step you have to take is whatever you're doing today, this day, all of your joining degree. So how do you become better in that? On that day, how will you attend classes? Listen to all the classes. What will you learn on that single day? How much have you learned? Make a note of it. And see how much, how far you've come in, say, maybe 365 days. You will not have college in all the days, but most of the days, how far you've come. Make a note of it. Have a book. Make a note of it. See how far you've come. See how much you've learned. It's those people who are going to succeed. So, there's a small story here about positive attitude. You know, one day a mosquito, went out flying for the first time. And when it came back, the dad asked, oh, how was your flying? How did you enjoy flying? And you know what the little mosquito said? He said, it was wonderful. Everyone was clapping for me. You see, what do we do when we see a mosquito around us? What do we do? What do? We clap. Are we actually clapping? We're trying to kill the mosquito. But instead of seeing it negatively, the mosquito thought that actually all the people were clapping for it. So it was excited. See how a small thing, even a negative thing, can be taken positively? So if you bring optimism into your life, it makes it easier to avoid worry and negative thinking. You know, there are some people who always worry about things that, maybe I'm going to miss the bus today. Maybe if they're going for a movie, we might not get tickets. Or it might rain looking at the, you know, things like that. So if they have that mindset, they're surely going to miss the bus. They're surely not going to get tickets. And maybe it's going to rain even. But thing is, if you think positively, there are chances that if you don't get the tickets, if you hang around for some time in the belief that something is going to happen and you will get the ticket, there are instances where I've been in those places. No tickets for the movie. Oh my God, I wanted to see it today. How come there are no tickets? And then just waited thinking, what am I going to do? What is the chance? Then instantly one person comes and said, my friends have just cancelled. I have 3 tickets. Do you need them? See? Positive person. Whenever you have that positive frame of mind, anything can happen. So remember that. So how do we have a positive attitude? First is honesty, commitment, confidence in yourself. courageous means you should be brave enough to take that first step, brave enough to challenge yourself, brave enough to have a target which you can set, which is slightly out of your comfort zone. Competitive. Today it's a competitive world, so unless you are competitive, you cannot move ahead. And open. This is one thing. You know, generally, when we go to a class or a movie, or we already have made up our mind that, okay, this is going to be like, that movie is very boring, or that movie is a hit, or that class is going to be boring. If you go with that sort of a mindset, it means you're not having a positive attitude. You should have an open mind. To think about what you will learn from that class. Think about what is different that you're going to achieve in that class. So then it makes it more interesting. Self-motivated, assertive, flexible. This is one point I like. You have to be flexible. You should be open for change. Sometimes, you know, even in class, what happens is when some person is always sitting in the back seat and we ask him to come to the front, he becomes very flustered. Madam, I'm comfortable here. Madam, I don't want to come. You know why? Because they're afraid of change. We like to, you know, sit in one place all the time, do the same thing again and again, because it gives us comfort. Our mind says you're comfortable here. But it's only when you get out of that comfort zone is when you're going to achieve something. A person with a positive mind will not think that, oh, madam has punished me and asked me to come and sit in the front. He will think, this is an opportunity for me to come and sit in the front and probably learn from the others, or maybe gives a chance for me to ask this teacher more questions, or, you know, see the board more clearly, or you can take it in any way. So be flexible, cooperative and nurturing. So I was telling you about objectives that you should have if you want to be positive. Any positive person should have these kind of objectives in mind. So, you know, whenever you're setting a target, I want to achieve something. I want to get at least 80% in my first semester, or between 80 and 85% in my first semester. How am I going to do that? I want to have 95% attendance in my first semester. How am I going to achieve that? So measurable. Don't say, I'm going to get 80% in whatever exam. So that's not a goal. Have goals that are measurable. If you have them measurable, you can measure it. You can decide, you can make changes in the next semester. If you feel that you have to get 85% in the first semester and you've not made it, maybe you've come to 72 or 75 and you've stopped there. So you know exactly what you have to do to make it better in the next sem. If you just say, I'm going to do well. So whenever I ask somebody, what do you want in life? I want to get a good job, ma'am. I want to have a good house, ma'am. I want to get into a good company, ma'am. What is good? What is a good job? For you, is 10,000 a good job? Is 20 a good job? Is 30 a good job? Is 40 per month a good job? What is a good job? So good is not a measure. He can say, I would like to get a job worth 30,000 a month or 25,000 a month. So, I would like to get a company which has this much of turnover or is in this sector. So when you give yourself such sort of targets which are measurable, it's easier to achieve them. Even if you don't achieve them, it's easier to know if you've achieved them or not. Unless, you know, why do we have exams in the end of the semester or the end of the year? It's just to see whether whatever you've been taught or whatever has been explained to you, how much of you have imbibed or absorbed or learned. All this, how much knowledge you've gained. Those tests are just for that. Not to make you feel bad that you've got a lower rank or higher rank. It's just to see how much of it you have absorbed. So similarly, you need some measure. Then attainable. Don't have targets or goals which are, I want to go become a space engineer. You are doing something, you're doing maybe BBA. How can you become a space engineer or go to the moon? You can't do that. So have them, you know, according to what you are, what you're doing, let them be attainable. Demanding. Don't have a small goal. Make it a big goal. A lion can think that, you know, okay, well, if I hunt once in 3 days, that's enough. So it will sleep, does it sleep for 2.5 days and the last half day does it hunt? No. Lion is always looking for some prey to hunt. Why? Because it knows that once it eats a big, prey, it can actually relax after eating for 2 days. So, your goal should be demanding. It should take more out of you. It should make you put in 150%. Don't think that if you're a 60% student, say, for this semester if I get 65, that's enough. That's not demanding. You'll actually be somewhere between 60 and 65. Then what have you achieved? Nothing. If you've just got 60, you might have achieved more than some others who have failed, but for your own standards, are you good enough? No. Consistent. Have long-term goals under the control. Goals should always be under your control. Like, you know, it's about education, about your exams, you know, they should be under your control. Don't have targets about something that is not under your control. You cannot do anything about it. And then deadline. Have a time frame. By this time next year, I want to, end of the semester, I want to get at least 85%. In my exam, or 100% in my attendance, or I want to pursue this hobby or learn speaking English by, don't say I want to learn, what is your goal? Madam, I am a Telugu medium student, I want to learn speaking English. When? Whenever, madam. In 3 years, I'll learn it sometime. You'll never learn it. If you give yourself that longer time, you're never going to finish it. You know why? Because there is no deadline. How do you know when you are supposed to, you know, do something up to there? You don't know. So have a deadline. Say, in the next 3 months, I'm going to, learn proper grammar. Next 3 months, I'm going to listen to a lot of audio, video, visual videos, or, you know, on TV. And then the next 3 months, I'm going to speak. All this while, I'm going to start speaking in English. So if you give yourself those deadlines, you will achieve something. So, this is another small story about how, without anything, somebody being positive, they achieve a lot. Let's see, this is just a hilarious, anecdote about the two business people, how a business person can convince another person being positive. So, the father, he tells his son, I want you to marry a girl of my choice. Son says, how will I love you? I will choose my own bride. Father says, but the girl is Bill Gates' daughter. And the son says, oh, then it's okay. Because he knows Bill Gates is a very rich guy. So he says, oh, then it's okay. And the next he goes to Bill Gates. The father goes to Bill Gates. And he says, I have a husband for your daughter. And Bill Gates says, but my daughter is very young. I don't want to see her married now. But the father says, but this man is a vice president of a bank. Oh, Bill Gates says, oh, really? Then it's okay. If he's a vice president of an international bank, then it's okay. And then that thing is there. Actually, he's not the vice president yet. Then he goes to the president of the World Bank. The father goes to the president of the World Bank. And he says, I have a young man to recommend to you as vice president. And the president says, oh, there are too many vice presidents already for this bank. I don't need anybody. And then he says, but then he's Bill Gates' son-in-law. And this president says, oh, then it's okay. He can be the vice president. In that case, it is okay. That is how business is done. So even if you have nothing, you can get anything, but your attitude should be positive. Doesn't mean this is true. Or things happen this way, but I'm sure you've seen many salespeople, when you go into the market, you want to buy a television. They give you so much positivity in their talk, pep talk, that you're convinced to buy it. It's only after you step out of the shop and then you think again, maybe you'll have second thoughts, but as long as you're there, they give you so much positivity, you're going to have a fantastic experience with this TV, if you're going to buy a TV, that you're going to have a smart TV where you can see your photographs, you can do your chat, you can download anything. It's a, you know, all sorts of things. So much positivity that you, oh my God, with this TV, my whole world is going to change. That's the impression they give you. That's how positivity works. So, what are the benefits? You have more happiness, and then you have greater power. You have the ability to inspire yourself and others, and you can surpass any difficulty. So attitude is attitude, thinking, and behavior. If you change comes from inside out, thinking logically in every situation. Behavior is when you're determined and disciplined. So how do you become positive? Spread a smile, think positive, think of the goodness of each day, and say please and thank you. Even simple things like wishing somebody a good morning every day. We don't have this habit of saying good morning to even our friends or, you know, hello. Only when we meet somebody, hi, and then you'll get into the topic. But see the smile on somebody's face when you say good morning, good day, or hello, how are you? Or, you know, when you wish your teachers. That is one thing you must all learn. You know, it's not about discipline actually, it's about good manners. When you see somebody who's higher than you or who's teaching you something, your parents, have you ever said thank you to them? Have you asked your mother with something with a please? Please, mother, can you give me breakfast dosa tomorrow? Or have you ever tried that? Try saying it. See how much difference that's going to make. Thank your parents for what have they done for you. Small things. You know, they get you a birthday gift. Try saying thank you. See the smile on their faces. Try saying thank you to your teacher after each class. Try saying please when you ask a question. Try saying good morning to everybody you meet. See the difference you're going to feel. You feel positive. You feel energized. You feel like smiling. And surely you'll see a smile on their face also. So if you really wanted to do something, you'll find a way, or you'll find excuses. Generally, when we give a project, there's always a mixed group in the class. There'll be a 75% who'll do their job. Madam, I completed it. But there'll be a 25% in the class which will say, why didn't you finish it? Madam, yesterday, something, they'll come up with some excuse. Both the batches had the same time. They had the same inputs. They had the same resources. But it is the people who are positive will come up with the job, will do the job, and people who are negative will have an excuse. So positive attitude, with a positive attitude, you can never have a bad day. And with a negative attitude, you can never have a good day. Remember that. So positive attitude is like a magnet for positive results. So, this, I think I will just give you a small, I promised you a video. I will just have that video in a minute. Okay, so here's a video that I promised you. I'll just give you a little background about it. This is a video of Harsha Bogle. He's an alumni of IIM Ahmedabad, and he was called for their convocation a few years later. And here, he speaks about how attitude is more important than ability or talent. So let's listen from his words and then decide for ourselves which is more important.
Talent is the most useless virtue you possess. It's what you do with that talent that
So, as Harsha Bogle was saying, it is not ability which takes you places, but it is not even talent, it is your attitude. Ability plus talent plus attitude takes you places. So, no matter how talented you are, how good you are, or how, you know, how much memory you have, or how well you can write, it doesn't matter. As long as you don't have that attitude, you will not get anywhere. So, attitude is everything. And today, I just wanted to introduce the word emotional intelligence to you. So, what is emotional intelligence? Nowadays, the word attitude is being changed or being spoken as emotional intelligence. So, what is emotional intelligence? Emotional intelligence is the key to success, they say. Why? Because it is the capacity for understanding our own feelings, the feelings of others, the feelings with the group around us, and motivating ourselves, and also having empathy for the person next to you or the others. To understand all this and then behave accordingly, this is emotional intelligence. So along with positive attitude, today you should have the necessary emotional intelligence to succeed. So my last word was, attitude is like a flat tire. I mean a bad attitude or a negative attitude. Unless you change it, you will not go anywhere. So try to change your positive. If you have a bad attitude, if you have a negative attitude, try to change it. You cannot say, hey, I'm okay like this. I'm not bothered. Let anybody think the way they want to think about me. I'm going to stay like this. But it will not take you long. If you want to get somewhere, if you want to achieve something, if you want to do something, you'd better change it. Because I'm sure all of you know that with a flat tire, with a puncture, you cannot go far. And minds are like parachutes. They work best. How does a parachute work? When it's closely tied up and packed, does a parachute really help you? People have died because their parachute hasn't opened. It's only when the parachute opens completely that it saves you. It saves a person. It gives you a soft landing. So even a mind is like a parachute. It works best when it is opened. So have an open mind. Have a positive mind. Try to take in everything. Absorb the best. You know, remember that and work hard. Try not to have excuses, but have, you know, positive changes in you to achieve something. So with that, I think we will come to the end of this positive attitude session. I hope you've liked it, and I hope you're going to make the necessary changes to have that positive attitude. If you don't have it already, try. Nothing comes easy, and nothing happens overnight. So, try to change your mindsets day by day. You know, every day is new. So every day, get up in the morning and tell yourself, today I'm going to do something, I'm going to learn something, whether even if it's a single word of English, a single word or a single, you know, definition or a single, or do a hobby, or I want to paint something, draw something, anything you think of it when you get up in the morning and do it that day. That is having a positive attitude. Give yourself the, you know, the confidence that you need. Pat yourself when you've done it. And then you will have come out as a person having a very good attitude, a positive attitude, and of course, being a success in whatever you do. Not everybody can be, you know, achieve 100% success. If some people can, you know, achieve up to 80%, that's fine. As long as you know that you've given it your best shot. You cannot be lazy in excuses and get 80%. Give it your best shot, then say that you've done your best. That's the positive attitude we are looking for. So, wish you all the best and see you in the next class with another interesting topic. Good day.